إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد My dear respected beloved brothers and sisters I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bring us back to the masajid. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all our a'mal sincerely for His sake. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. My brothers and sisters, one of the best time to make dua during the month of Ramadan is just about when we are to break our fast. When we are about to break the fast, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, this is a great time for the dua to be mustajab. And among the best du'as to be said at that time is Allahumma a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Allahumma a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Ya Allah, save our necks from the hell fire. Why? Why is this one of the greatest du'a to say at that time? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us that وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاءُ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free people from the hellfire and that is every single night. Every single night of the nights of Ramadan. And I am begging him at that time where the du'a is mustajab to make my name among the people who will be saved. What does it mean, my brothers and sisters, al-itq min al-nar? What does to be, when we say someone's neck is freed from the hellfire, what does that mean? That means that the person will never enter Jahannam, will never enter the hellfire, and he will have one ticket, one-way ticket straight to Jannah. Straight to Jannah. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that this year, in one of these nights, you were from the people whom that He saved from the hellfire, He decreed that they will be from the people who will be saved from the hellfire, then the rest of your life, you will be performing the ibadat, the actions of the people of Jannah. Allahumma a'tiq riqabana minan nar, ya Rabbal Alameen. And not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be your mawla. He will be your protector. He will be your helper. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the mawla of the believers. And there are some people, my brothers and sisters, listen carefully in Surah Al-Hadid. There are some people whom the nar, whom the hellfire is their mawla. مَأْوَاكُمُ النَّارِ هِيَ مَوْلَاكُمْ Allahu Akbar. Look at the difference. Some people, Allah, their mawla. May Allah make us among them. And some people, the hellfire is their mawla. My brothers and sisters, do not give up. Even though 14 nights are gone, but there are 15 more opportunities to have our names among the people who will be saved from the hellfire. Who are some of the people that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that if they do these a'mal, they will be from the people who will be saved from the hellfire? First, Utbah bin Malik al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu qal, Ghada alayya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam wa qal, Lan yuwafi abdun yawm al-qiyama, yaqul la ilaha illa Allah, yabtaghi bihi wajha Allah, illa harrama Allah alayhi an-nar. Wal hadith fi al-Bukhari. Utbah radiyallahu anhu, he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to me one time and he said, if anybody comes on the day of judgment saying La ilaha illallah sincerely with the intention to win Allah pleasure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the hellfire forbidden for him. Allah will make the hellfire forbidden for him. La ilaha illallah mukhlisan. Just La ilaha illallah. That means no one is worthy of my worship except Allah. No one is worthy of my obedience except Allah. No one is worthy to please except Allah. No one is worthy to fear except Allah. No one is worthy to rule except Allah Azza wa Jal. Sincerely for the sake of Allah. This person, subhanallah, he hides his good deeds just like he hides his evil deeds. This person, all he cares about is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as Allah know about it, I do not really care if anybody else know. Subhanallah. Ikhlas, ya akhwan. Sincerity. One of the beautiful definitions of sincerity is to forget the vision of the creation by constantly looking at the Creator. Allahumma ja'alna min al-mukhlisin, ya rabbal alameen. So the first one is the one who sincerely say La ilaha illallah. Live by La ilaha illallah. Act upon La ilaha illallah. Not just lip service. La ilaha illallah. May Allah make La ilaha illallah our last word. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Second, thalathatun. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thalathatun la tara a'yunuhumun nar. Subhanallah. Who's saying this, ya akhwan? As-sadiq al-ameen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's saying, thalathatun la tara a'yunuhumun nar. A'inun harasat fi sabilillah. Wa'inun bakat min khashyatillah. Wa'inun ghaddat an maharimillah. Wal hadith sahih fi at-tabarani. Three kinds of eyes, three kinds of people whom their eyes will never see the hellfire. The first is an eye that was guarding in the cause of Allah. And the second is an eye that weeps out of fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the third is an eye that is lowered when it sees anything that is not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first one is an eye that guarded, an eye that was in the front line guarding the soldiers in jihad. Subhanallah. People who are guarding the people who are fighting fi sabilillah. And the second is an eye that cried out of the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. My beloved brothers and sisters, when was the last time you cried? When was the last time you shed a tear out of fear of Allah Azza wa Jal? These are the nights of weeping, ya akhwan. Our ulama used to say, if 1 week passed by and you did not cry, you have to check your heart. Check your heart, something is wrong. When was the last time you cried? And when we are alone and we shed a tear of the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that we will be under the shade of Allah when there is no shade except His shade. Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he said something very beautiful. He said, Allah combined those two eyes, the one that guards and the one that cried, because both of them are up at night. One crying out of the fear of Allah, and the other is out of the protecting the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the third eye, my brothers and sisters, and especially my brothers, is an eye that lowered its gaze, is a person that lowers his gaze when he sees anything that's haram. A person that when something pops on his screen, he immediately says astaghfirullah and he delete immediately. He changes the screen immediately. The person that lowers his gaze when he's faced by anything haram. Be careful with these days while we are sitting at home. Be careful. Don't let these eyes, don't let the vision gaze and stare at people, at things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. Third, my brothers and sisters, listen to this. Glad tidings to the one whom Allah blessed with girls. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من كان له ثلاث بنات فصبر عليهن وأطعمهن وسقاهن وكساهن من جدته كن له حجابا من النار يوم القيامة. والحديث في ابن ماجة. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whomsoever Allah blessed with three daughters and he was patient toward them, he fed them, he gave them drink, he clothed them from his wealth, they will be a shield for him from the fire on the day of judgment. We have cultures that they complain when they are blessed with daughters. My brothers and sisters, listen to this hadith. We can make our daughters and the way we raise them a reason for us to be saved from the hellfire. Hijab, a barrier between the person who raised, and be patient. Subhanallah, be patient with them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all our daughters. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Fourth, my brothers and sisters, something that we could all practice, insha'Allah ta'ala. من حافظ على أربع قبل الظهر وأربع بعدها حرمه الله على النار. Subhanallah. Whomsoever prays regularly four rak'ah before dhuhr and four rak'ah after dhuhr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forbid him from entering the hellfire. Let's make this as a new habit, insha'Allah ta'ala. Let's make this a new habit, and we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from the people who will continue to perform it after Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار يا رب العالمين. ألا أخبركم بمن تحرم عليه النار على كل قريب هين لين سهل. سبحان الله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, shall I inform you whom will be the hellfire will be forbidden to touch, will be forbidden to touch? The one who is accessible, the one who is polite, the one who has a tender nature, and the one who is easy to deal with. Subhanallah. There are some people, wallahi, you have to think 100 times about every word before you speak to them. There are some people, you immediately, when you see them, you feel very, very uncomfortable. My brothers and sisters, now you are in the lockdown. Wallahi, it is the best time to apply this hadith, and insha'Allah ta'ala, you will get that ajr. Be easy in the way you deal with one another. Do not be stubborn. Take advantage of this time and build your relationship. Be kind and gentle to the way you speak to one another. We are hearing horror stories of what's happening at homes. Please remember this hadith. Hayyin, sahl, subhanallah. Look at the terms that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used. Do not be very demanding. You need to be easy to approach. Respect one another. Please, brothers and sisters, respect one another. Take advantage of this time to rejuvenate the relationship between each other. إِنَّ اللَّهَ, and remember, subhanallah, the hadith is in Bukhari, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ ثَلَاثْ عُقُوقِ الْأُمَّهَاتْ وَوَأْدِ الْبَنَاتْ وَمَنْعًا وَهَاتْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made haram three things: burying the daughters when they are alive, disobeying the mothers, and look at the third one, مَنْعًا وَهَاتْ, withhold your dues and ask and demand your rights. Withhold your dues and demand your rights. How many people are practicing this? I am the man. I am the man, if you don't do this to me, you're going to hell. And he's not performing his dues. Similarly, the wife doing the same thing. My brothers and sisters, harrama alaykum thalath. They are haram to ask what for your rights, and you do not give your dues. Some people, subhanallah, they are abusing one another at this time of lockdown. Please take advantage and be hayyin, sahil. The person who is hayyin and sahil and qareeb is the person when you ask him to forgive somebody, he said, okay, no problem. He, not like the other person who is, no way, wallahi, I will never forgive him no matter what happened. This is not an easy person. This is not the one who's mentioned in this hadith. A person who you come to him, wallahi, I know that the debt is due. Can you give me another 2 weeks? He says, no problem. This is what we're talking about. He's the hayyin, subhanallah. Be hayyin, ya akhwan. Be easy to deal with. Be easy to approach. And insha'Allah ta'ala, you will be from the people who will be saved from the hellfire. Subhanallah. Lend me your ears, my brothers and sisters. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا إله إلا الله. Whomsoever says لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله وحده. لا إله إلا الله لا شريك له. لا إله إلا الله له الملك وله الحمد. لا إله إلا الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. The hadith is صحيح عن سنة بن ماجة. What happens يا رسول الله? Listen carefully يا الله. من رزقهن عند موته لم تمسه النار. Allahu Akbar. Whomsoever, look at the word Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used. It's a rizq from Allah Azza wa Jal. Whomsoever has been blessed by saying these five statements on their deathbed, the fire, the hellfire will not touch them. They will not see the hellfire. They will not enter Jahannam. How can I make these words my last words? By practicing them on a daily basis. By keeping the word La ilaha illallah on my tongue. Always on my tongue. Always. La ilaha illallah is the word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets because. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the books because of La ilaha illallah. Allah created the heavens and the earth because of La ilaha illallah. Whomsoever ruziqahunna, who has given this rizq, and this rizq is only from Allah Azza wa Jal. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters, I beg Allah Azza wa Jal to make our last words La ilaha illallah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. I beg Allah Azza wa Jal to remind us of these statements on our deathbed. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. My brothers and sisters, it has been noticed that many people's energy and excitement start declining when we pass the first 10 nights of Ramadan. My brothers and sisters, it is still Ramadan. And still these nights are the nights where lists are made of people who will be saved from the hellfire. Let's get back and revive that energy. Let's revive our intention. Let's get back to the prayers and the reading of the Quran. Not because the masajid are closed. We should start, you know, slowing our ibadat. No, my brothers and sisters, every single day is still Ramadan. The daytime and the nighttime are Ramadan. And these are the nights where people are saved from the hellfire. My brothers and sisters, the best nights are about to come. The best nights, when the next khatib will be standing here next week, the last 10 nights of Ramadan would have started. Allahu Akbar. These nights where they have a night in them, one night is more rewarding than 83 years of ibadah. Start planning, ya akhwan. These are the days of sari'u. These are the days of sabiqu. These are the days of racing. And if I want to go to the race, I want to go to the marathon, I have to prepare from now. These nights are coming. The nights where we give up some of the sleep. These are the nights you have 350 days to sleep. These are the 10 nights where we struggle and beg Allah Azza wa Jal and beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the neck, save our necks from the hellfire. Allahumma ballighna laylatul qadr ya rabbal alameen. Rabbana asrif anna azaab jahannam. Inna azaabaha kana gharama. Rabbana asrif anna azaab jahannam. Inna azaabaha kana gharama. My brothers and sisters, I ask Allah azza wa jal to accept our fasting, to accept our qiyam, to accept our donations, to accept our reading of the Quran, and to answer every single dua. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma waffiqna lima tuhibbuhu wa tardah. Allahumma a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Ya Allah, I ask you the best of your names, everyone who's attending and everyone who's watching. Ya Allah, save their necks from the hellfire. Ya Allah, save their necks from the hellfire. Allahumma rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata ayun waj'alna lilmuttaqina imama. Rabbana آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. My dear brothers and sisters, please do not forget the masjid with your donations. These are the months of giving. This is the month of everything is multiplied. Please donate and help your masajid, and especially here at EPIC with all the services that we are providing, inshaAllah ta'ala. May Allah accept from all of us and protect us all, inshaAllah ta'ala. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa qumu ila salatikum.